Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, in today's video, I want to discuss every single diet form that I tried during my lifetime. So, to begin with this video, we have to go way, way back. My first dietary intervention, I started out when I was 12 years old. When I was around about 9 years, I got very obese because as any kid, I liked the junk food, I liked the candies and all that stuff, and I indulged heavily in it. When I was 11 years old, I couldn't take it anymore. I was reminded that once upon a time, when I was 8, 7, or 6, I was the skinny kid, and therefore I couldn't accept this new identity of being this fat kid. I looked like the bullies that I used to know from my school, and I didn't want to identify with that persona. Therefore, I was praying to God every single night. I'm not religious by any means anymore, but back in the day as a kid, I had only that outlet, so to speak. Every night I would lay in bed and I would pray to God, to Jesus Christ, to give me the secret to weight loss. Every single night I would pray to the Heavenly Father to give me some sort of sign. How do I lose weight? Because let's face it, back in the day, there was no internet. Nowadays, you have an abundance of information. Anyways, it was one of those days where my mother took me with her to a friend of hers. She and the friend were sitting around drinking coffee, talking about lady stuff. And I was the only kid there being bored out of my mind. So therefore, I started searching for toys, for anything I could play with in that flat of the lady friend of my mom. After half an hour being bored to death, I found a ladies magazine. And on that ladies magazine, the cover page says, "The secret to weight loss." Right? So I, as a little kid, I was convinced God sent me a sign. This is it. So I checked the index and it said page number 4, the secret to weight loss. I will never forget that day. I was so excited. My heart was pounding. I couldn't wait to find out about the secret to weight loss. Page number 4 says the secret to weight loss is stop eating after 8 p.m. That was it. Back then, as I said, we didn't have more information. So therefore, I took that piece of advice. It was the only thing that I could get. And I applied it straight away. So therefore, to cut it as short as I can, my first dietary intervention was intermittent fasting. I did it around about 20 years ago. It is a beautiful example of that information can paralyze you in many ways. Nowadays, we have an abundance of information on the internet, but it's still very, very hard for people to apply that knowledge. But back in the day, as I said, I just had that piece of advice and I applied it straight away. For me, it was a message of God. From 12 to 16 years old, I was intermittent fasting. And I felt pretty good with it because I got the results. I lost all the weight and of course I hit puberty, so therefore I was growing and my hormones kicked in, needless to say. So therefore I did a complete transformation. From the fat, chubby little kid, I transformed into the skinny teenager. But then I was too skinny and therefore I decided now it's time to build some muscle. When I was 16 years old, I started out with a bodybuilding diet. First, I started out with just eating as many calories as I could. I experimented with protein powders, with creatine, was eating a lot of cottage cheese, was eating a lot of meats. But then after a while, I got the hang of it and I did the bro diet, so to speak. I started eating rice and chicken religiously, if you will, 6 times per day, with a couple of exceptions. Sometimes I would have a little bit of beef, sometimes a little bit of tuna, but the main frame was rice and chicken 6 times per day. And it worked tremendously, I'm not gonna lie. It was very, very efficient, and back in that time, I was convinced that I found out about the truth. I thought, all my life, intuitively, I've been craving carbs and fats, and they sure as hell taste good, but they don't deliver results. If I eat protein, I see my complete body composition changing. That was absolutely true at that time. Once I started eating those foods that I intuitively didn't like at all, I completely transformed and I developed tremendously in the gym. So for muscle gains, that diet was perfect, needless to say. To this very day, you can see it on the Olympia stage, professional bodybuilders still eat in that style. Rice and chicken, rice and beef, so on and so forth. A high protein diet with moderate carbohydrates with low amounts of fat. For muscle building, it was perfect. Even as a vegan, I have to admit that. But then after a while, I thought I want to experiment with other diet forms. Maybe there is something that I don't know yet. And therefore, I started out with the ketogenic diet. The ketogenic diet never suited me. I always felt a lack of energy, even though I ended up doing it for 1 year straight. In that year, I had different periods. First, I tried out with dairy, with a couple of cheeses, with Greek yogurt, so on and so forth, but it didn't really work. The high amount of lactose in those foods would kick me out of ketosis. Therefore, I tried to find a cheese that had zero carbs, but even that didn't agree with me. Cheese, milk products in general, would always make me puffy. I didn't enjoy them. For the performance, I would feel sluggish and my overall look would be watery. So therefore, pretty soon I had to realize that I have to cut out every dairy product. So I ended up eating just meat and eggs. Even the eggs gave me some sort of sluggish feeling. I never enjoyed it. And if I would leave the eggs aside and eat only meat, I realized that I look much more crisp. You can call that bro science, I'm just sharing my experience. Every time I would cut out eggs and dairy, I would always look much, much better. And therefore, after 2 months or so, I decided to go full-blown carnivore. This is why I stated in previous videos, I did the carnivore diet before it was called the carnivore diet. I never knew about it, I just applied my bodybuilding knowledge to it of complete proteins that are found in animal products. And therefore I said, hey, you know what, Greek yogurt, cheese, the biological value of those products is around about 70%. Meat, on the other hand, is much, much higher. And therefore, I'm gonna stick with red meat, some chicken here and there, and high amounts of animal fats in general. But as I said, that diet didn't work for me at all. I felt sluggish overall, even after just eating meat. I didn't get a good pump in the gym. I was flat all the time, obviously because you don't have carbohydrates to fuel your glycogen stores. And overall, the taste was just disgusting, to be honest. Even in rice and chicken days, I was always craving more rice. I'm not making a point here that therefore you should be eating more rice, but overall it was just absolutely unappealing to me because all I had to eat was meat. After a while, it became very, very boring. On that note, people ask me if I tried it raw. Yes, back in the day when I was doing the carnivore diet, I was eating some raw meat, some raw fish, the raw eggs as well. I had a period where I would have, I believe, up to 6 raw eggs every morning. So therefore I tried it both ways and I truly didn't enjoy it. And I personally didn't have a benefit. I would always perform better with rice, with carbohydrates in general. Therefore, after that experiment, I went back to a bro diet. If you've been following me, you know I always was a vegan at heart. I always hated the animal agriculture, the animal industry. And therefore, after being again back on the bro diet, I started feeling very, very conscious about the animals that I've been consuming. And therefore, I decided to essentially choose the lesser of the two evils and I went for a pescetarian diet. I said I still need my complete proteins and therefore I'm just gonna stop eating land animals altogether. And I have to say, I felt fantastic. Ethically, at that point, I was all right with my decisions. I didn't really have that deep connection when it comes down to fish. And performance-wise, I have to say that I felt absolutely fantastic. At that point of time, I really felt great. My sleep was good. My shape was always good. It was really effortless to stay in shape whilst being pescetarian. Don't get me wrong, I have to mention this. On every single diet, I always tracked my macros, but I really have to say that there is something in it that when you eat fish, you really start leaning out. The calories were the exact same, no matter if I was eating beef or chicken or fish, but on fish, I always found that fish would lean me out without any effort. So therefore, I have to say, to this very day, I have to admit that the pescetarian diet suited me very, very well. Just a little side note before I continue. I really hate the taste of animal products, but I hate fish the most. I really hate, it disgusts me just thinking of it, the taste of fish. As I said, performance-wise, it was great. I felt amazing overall, really. And ethically, at that point in time, it was all right. But the taste was always a big hurdle for me. So therefore, even though I felt good, it was not a taste preference. I'm not romanticizing that diet because it tasted so good. It was really just due to the benefits that I would get performance-wise and shape-wise. So, moving along, at some point, that diet had to come to an end as well. Because I was confronting myself with the animal agriculture and with industrial fishing. Because let's be honest, even though it is wild caught, it is still a big industry that you are supporting. And therefore, I couldn't do it anymore. I said to myself, I'm just gonna eat wild caught game meat now. That must be the way. And let's be honest, again, I felt pretty good on that diet. I was eating kangaroos, I was eating crocodiles, bison, stuff like that. I was eating wild animals, and I have to say that I felt good. Maybe not as good as a pescetarian, but I didn't really have a performance down or anything. Not an increase either, I felt overall just okay. Taste-wise, I really have to admit, it was much more appealing to me than eating fish all day long. That is a taste preference, and that doesn't play into the conclusion of those single diets. Because what I want to talk about in this video is how I really felt and how I performed and how my health was at that time. Anyways, after eating wild animals for a while, I couldn't continue with that either anymore. So therefore I said, this is it. Either I'm going to become a hunter and I'm going to kill my own animals, or I'm going to be congruent with myself and I'm going to be a vegetarian. That was it back in the day. I didn't know about veganism, and therefore I said, I'm going to become a vegetarian then. Because if I cannot kill it myself, there's something wrong here. So I became a vegetarian and I was eating very protein rich. So that means I was eating a ton of eggs, I was eating a ton of light cheese, and I was eating Greek yogurt. And let me tell you, out of all of those diets, vegetarianism was the worst. I felt completely shit. It was the most sluggish that I ever felt. I was weak, I felt puffy, I lost my shape, I just looked like a block of cheese, pretty much. You are what you eat. So therefore, vegetarianism didn't suit me at all. It was horrible. Again, I was counting my macros. It was all the same, but I was losing shape and size. It just didn't appeal to me at all. From a digestive point, it didn't agree with me at all. Everybody knows those digestive issues when you're eating eggs and cheese. So it was overall horrible. Pretty soon, I ditched it and I got back to pescetarian again. That has always suited me the best. But after a while and after a couple of more psychedelic experiences, I couldn't cope with that guilt anymore. I didn't want to be the guy that has dominion over the animals. At that point of time, I didn't see my place as this conqueror of all animals. I want to live in a symbiotic relationship with everything to be at peace. And therefore I said to myself, even if I lose all my gains, I will become vegan. What I did in the beginning, and I talked about this in previous videos, was very, very cautious. I would eat rice with 2 cans of tuna, and I would slowly replace it with tofu. I would take away 1 can of tuna, and I would replace it with 1 pack of tofu. So it was still half animal-based and half plant-based. Slowly but surely, I would gradually become vegan. And let me tell you one thing. Once I was 100% plant-based, I felt amazing. I never felt so good in my life. This is the honest to God truth. When I went vegan the very first time, I had such an unlimited energy, it was unbelievable. And I asked myself, how can that be? Because with my background, I always tracked my macros and I always ate clean food. I never was into junk food or pizza since I started intermittent fasting as a 12-year-old. I left all of that behind me. The last time that I really was indulging in dirty foods was when I was 12 years old. After that, sure, the occasional cheat meal, but overall, I would always have a clean diet, no matter if it was ketogenic, pescetarian, vegetarian, so on and so forth. And now all of a sudden, I'm on this vegan diet, and I feel absolutely amazing. I ask myself, how can that be? So therefore, there must be something here. I'm onto something. This must be the right diet for me. This was truly my belief system at that point. Because I didn't come from a sad diet background and out of a sudden I feel good because I eliminated all the bad foods. Quite the opposite. All I was eliminating was basically the fish. Everything else stayed the same. I essentially was eating the same aside from the fish. And I felt fantastic. They say never change a winning system, but the curious mind that I am, I had to experiment further. So therefore I started with water fasts, I started with juice fasts, I went fully raw vegan, and then I ended up being fully fruitarian. I was fruitarian for around about 1.5 years, and in the beginning I felt great. I was very spiritually aligned, but very, very soon I had to realize that I was losing tons of muscle. At that time, I thought I'm cleansing myself, I'm getting rid of all the old karma, if you will, and now I'm becoming this pure being. Fruits have the highest energy, the highest frequency, and therefore it is the only thing that really digests well, and this is truly the food of the gods. This is truly what we are supposed to be eating. I was 100% convinced. Looking back into my past, everything seemed so grotesque. What have I been doing? Eating all that animal protein, right? I thought I was truly brainwashed back in the day. All that protein is not for human consumption. All we need are the amino acids from fruits. Even though fruits only have 1 gram of protein per fruit, I still was convinced that that is all we need, that this is all we need to build muscle, to be healthy, so on and so forth. Very soon I had to realize that I was in a dogmatic belief system. I was trapped in an ideology, in a religion, if you will, in a fruit cult. And this is why I still give the fruitarians so much shit, because nutritionally it's just not adequate. Philosophically speaking, it is a very, very beautiful thought, a beautiful dream. But if you really want to apply it and you want to perform good, you want to be healthy overall, unfortunately, it doesn't work. And I had to learn it the hard way. Pretty soon, I lost my libido, I lost all my muscle, as I said, and I couldn't sit on a chair for longer than 20 minutes because my bones would stick out. I started looking anorexic. And to be honest here, I was anorexic in that sense because I believed this state of being with no extra fat, with no extra muscles, looking like a yogi, an ascet, this is what we are supposed to be as humans. So therefore, after realizing that I essentially brainwashed myself, I went back to raw veganism and I started counting calories, macros, micros again. I started implementing a lot of seeds, a lot of nuts, a lot of greens. I had those huge salad bowls. I still had fruit as a primary fuel source. And slowly but surely, I started reintroducing raw protein powders. That diet suited me for a while, and my body thanked me that I was giving it some type of nutrition. But even that diet wasn't sustainable long term. I saw my body still declining. I just couldn't maintain a general state of well-being, a general state of strength and health. Quite the opposite. I was always agitated, I was always angry, or let's say hangry, and I was just drag. I experienced panic attacks, anxiousness, so on and so forth. And after a while, I had to say, this is it. I have to end this. What is the harm in a sweet potato? So after experimenting with certain cooked foods, I saw that they were very, very well digestible for me. I had no issues whatsoever. Quite the opposite, they started fueling my body again. So I went back to a whole food plant-based diet, as I did when I started out with veganism, and I started feeling better by the day. This is the status quo of things. Now I find myself being on a whole food plant-based diet for over 1 year. I have to say that I still feel like I am recovering of that raw vegan time. I really have to say that. And I'm not trying to give you guys shit. If you want to be raw vegan, please do so. I always said that on this channel. No matter what you choose to do, more power to you. You want to be raw vegan, you want to be vegan, you want to be fruitarian, you want to be carnivore, more power to you. This journey is about you, not about me. I can only give my advice, my perspective, my experience. If it helps you, that is great. I'm just doing this to share. We are all still learning, or at least we should be. Every time you find yourself in some dogmatic belief, you really have to start questioning it, because how can it hold true? This is something that I had to learn the hard way, not only through raw veganism or what have you, but if I'm looking back to every single diet form that I've been doing, I always thought that it is the ultimate truth at that moment of time. But as I said in previous videos, it is true for that moment of time, but it is not the ultimate truth, and it doesn't mean that it will be true tomorrow. Anyways, to come back to the current state of things, right now I'm on a whole food plant-based diet and I do feel good. But do I feel as good as I used to when I started out with veganism? No. That is the true answer here. I always kept it real on this channel. Therefore, what I want to share here is my personal truth. And the truth is, at the moment, I feel okay. I do not feel as if I have those vegan superpowers that I used to have when I started out with veganism. Since I did all those cleanses, my health overall has declined. That is just the case. As for right now, I feel okay. I have good skin, I feel fit, I am building muscle, but do I feel 100%? I would disagree. So therefore, to sum up this video, I truly have to admit, out of all of those diets, temporary, I felt the best on the vegan diet. Long term, I felt the best on the pescetarian diet. That is just the truth, and I'm not afraid to admit it. This channel has always been an honest self-expression. This is my perspective. I always share my truth, and I know that some people will get pissed off, and I know that some people will appreciate it. And let's be honest here, if you are in a healthy mental state, you will appreciate different perspectives, even if they attack your ideology. Alright guys, and this is it for today's video. It has been way too long. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. If you want to support me on Patreon, you can head over there. If you haven't signed up in the forum of my homepage, www.bobbysperspective.com, I appreciate the support. If you like this video, leave me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And as always guys, much love. And peace.